director here at the Philly Student Studios in the South Florida region. And I'm here today with you doing a cha-cha-cha, and we're gonna try to talk a little bit about the Cuban breaks, which is one of our favorite steps in the cha-cha and very, very famous. So I'm gonna try to show you the step first, and then we're gonna try to break it down. Right? The first we're gonna do at Cuban breaks two with the left and four and one with the right and three and four and one. That's all we're gonna have is split Cuban break. Two and three and four and one. Okay, I'm gonna turn around and we're gonna break it down. What do we have to do for the steps? Step forward, checking action. We'll get the knees together and release the back knee. Transfer the weight on the back leg. Part weight on the side step. Replace the weight on the right leg. Again, repeat the same thing. Transfer the weight and finish with a side step. We're gonna do the same thing with the right leg. And two, knees together, and three, and four, and finish with a side step, okay? Now, I'll try to do that facing the camera so you can see what we're doing. We're gonna go forward, and two, transfer the weight, and three, and four, and one, and the same with another leg, two, and three, and four, and one, and. Now, when we are doing a Cuban break and we are trying to keep the hip action going, every single time when I'm stepping on the leg, my hip is going on the standing leg. So if I step with the right leg, my hip goes towards the right leg. The same when I transfer the weight, my hip goes to my left, and so far and so on. Each time my hip is dancing towards the dancing leg. And we do the same with the left. My hip goes on the left leg, on the right, on the left, on the right, on the left, on the right, and on the standing leg again. So I'm gonna try to turn around so you can follow me. Let's do it together. And go two and three and four and one, two and three and four and one. Very nice. Now, split Cuban breaks. Split Cuban breaks means that we're doing it only one time and it's a little bit faster. We're gonna try to do it together. So it's the same action as the first step. We'll go checking action, replace the weight, step to the side, exhale, check, collect, and go to the side. And the count will be like this. Two and three, the four and one. We're gonna turn around to do that one more time with you. So we're gonna step with the left foot across in two and three and four and one. Very nice. Now this step can be made dancing in front of the partner, side by side to the partner, or in the couple when we are rotating. So I'm gonna try to explain you how we can rotate with this step. If I'm doing a Cuban break, I can rotate each time, which is dancing with a partner, imaginary partner of mine now. Yes, we can go and do our Cuban breaks, rotating each time. To the left, we come back to the right. We go to the left, to the right, and the same I can do with another leg. I go and two, and three, and four, and one, and I'm gonna do the split Cuban breaks the same way. Two, and three, and four, and one. So that is a good exercise for you if you wanna try to do it by yourself. And we're gonna try to do that with the music now.
Yeah.
Cuban breaks, and Cuban breaks with the rotation, I did a little bit slower. I did it twice slower speed because we usually use the partner for the rotation, so it's easier to bounce off of each other and it's helping with the speed. So when you're gonna start practicing it, try first slower, yes, and then you can speed it up a little bit because with the real speed, it's really quick and it's a little bit harder to do by ourselves. So as far as the Cuban breaks goes, one more thing I would like to kind of talk about, a little bit, little tiny detail. When we're going after the checking action forward and we go to the side, yes, we're starting from the flex knee and then the knees are switching. It goes from the one bend to another one. It's not good enough to dance in the two straight legs all the time. Yes, so we're releasing one knee, then releasing the right leg again. It's constantly, the knees are dancing. That's what makes our hips move and makes a little bit nicer action than just dancing with the two straight legs all the time. Okay, so I hope you guys liked it. And I think that next time we're gonna talk a little bit more about the cha-cha-cha and other actions. I hope that you're gonna have a little questions or comments, and please subscribe to the channel. Or if you have some questions, please take a look at the video and you'll see what we talked about before, about the legs, about the knees action. And so looking forward to see you guys, and till the next time, bye.